Dude. Yeah, absolutely.
Absolutely.
Dude.
Absolutely.
Dude, absolutely.
Everybody.
Everybody.
Hey now.
What's up, guys?
Dude,
hey. Gal?
How you pissing?
Actually, though, do you want to know?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not quite sure. It's been weird.
Really?
I had some hot pee lately.
Some crystals in there?
No. Just more hot than crystally. You know what I mean? Like where you feel it coming in and you're like, that's warm. And also it stinks a little bit. And you're like, I'm not malnourished. And I definitely don't. I think Adderall
you
does
drink
that.
Water.
Yeah, a lot of water.
Yeah.
I think Adderall does that to your piss.
Mm, yeah. I know the Strateria that I take dries me the fuck out. My pussy is like a desert.
You're looking a little chapped down there, buddy.
Is there like a specific ingredient?
No, that's Mara.
Asparagus.
Yeah, it might be that. I think it's
sulfur.
I think it's just one of the side effects in that it dries you out a little bit. Cause like I've been having some very golden pee lately, where like I drink a lot of water.
You know what I always think of when I see my pee is like very yellow? Is that Dane Cook bit? You know what I'm talking about? Mm-hmm. He's talking about how he's talking to somebody on the phone while he's taking a piss, and he's like,
"Oh, the
it was a very yellow. It had a lovely hue."
Yeah, one of the funniest pee color things I've ever heard in my life. It's kind of funny. So we had this like thing at the end of the hockey season when we were in like the youth program growing up, where it was called Scholastic Achievement. My mom actually used to run it, but
oh,
so like if you were on the B or A honor roll, you were included in this. It was basically just like you got to walk up and get like a bag of free shit. And then they had a bunch of prizes at the end. And they just gave away all these prizes to a bunch of different players in the whole organization. So there's like, you know, 35 teams represented there. And every kid from every team pretty much is there. So anyway, a bunch of us won a free pass to a 3 week or 6 week long, like dryland training course, and we all showed up to like the first day or whatever, and they're like kind of walking through some nutritional stuff with us, and the coach was like, ideally you want your pee to be like a lighter yellow to clear. And this kid that we called him Fish Kid growing up Fish Kid just goes, what if it's brown? It was awesome. We were in fucking fifth grade. It was like, dude, you're brilliant. It was so funny.
Do they have an answer? Brown?
The guy was like, what? He's like, nah, I'm kidding.
Oh, man.
Yeah, he got that nickname because his dad's email address was Fish Guy. So
the first person that ever was like, I'm going to pee on someone because it makes me horny. They weren't nutritionally adequate.
Maybe. Because
they called it golden showers.
That reminds me.
We don't know if the first event was given the namesake, you know?
Dudes, I came up with a new your mom joke because I was hearing some comedians trying to come up with new ones. Your mom
You didn't want to workshop what it could have been before golden shower? Oh. I'm just keep going.
No, I'm in on the golden shower talk after this.
Oh, so. I thought it was done. I'm sorry.
No, we were going to contemplate the origins of golden shower, but go ahead.
I think that because of the gods, right? Who was the one that would eat the grapes? Is it Bacchus?
Oh, Pac-Man.
Pac-Man. So the Roman god Pac-Man, right? He would just sit and gobble up those grapes. And then people were like, we want the wine from the gods. And he was like, I got your wine. And then
punched him in the face. Such a dad joke.
He's so fucking yellow. Obviously, his pee has got to be more yellow. So it's like gold.
So your mom is that your mom?
No, I went back into workshopping with you guys.
Who is this guy?
Dude, Midas would like never know
Ooh.
If their pee was
also,
healthy or not.
How much hubris do you have if you're naming an auto body shop after a Greek god?
Oh, the Midas Touch?
The Midas Touch? Hey, fuck off. You help people's carburetors operate better.
They would have to extract it, maybe, from Midas.
The urine?
Yeah.
Yeah, probably.
Even then, maybe their bladder lining.
So my theory is that like there was just a brothel that was like their thing.
Mm-hmm. And it's just all they drank was alcohol.
Oh, no. That, yeah, sure. I guess.
I'm just trying to think of something they dehydrate.
There was just so much piss happening there that inevitably more of it was yellow than was clear. Plus it was like a...
Well, people had nutrient issues.
Yeah.
Years and years
ago.
Yeah,
they were more focused on the fucking, the sucking, and the...
Methamphetamines. There was a big drought.
There was, yeah.
And that's like, when the golden showers came right. about.
Yeah, yeah.
But it was a wild time.
Yeah, you'd go to like the brothel that they did the piss, and then people would be like, what can I get
oh,
you?
Oh, brothel. Broth.
Yeah, right, right. And the guy's it's like, I'll together. Have a golden...
It's all coming together.
Were we not gold- talking about soup?
Oh, yeah, well, that was...
There's a specific kind of soup.
That was totally not what I intended, but I'm claiming it as.
What are we? What intention. Are we bowling here,
dude? I did that yesterday.
1985.
Did Steve tell you that?
He did.
Okay, because that offended him
what,
deeply.
Going bowling or?
Yeah, I was playing Dark Souls and I was playing online, so there's the player notes everywhere.
Yeah.
And it said like praise the soup, and I'm like soup. Where the fuck is the soup? And then a few minutes later, I'm like, where the fuck is this soup? Do I have to bowl for it? And then he was like, all right, hold on.
You?
Yeah.
You piece of shit.
Yeah. So your mom joke, and then I'm going to talk about Steve.
No, your mom joke, then we're talking.
All right, fine.
Then you're talking.
Sick talk.
Nice.
Your mom's so poor she couldn't afford a golden shower.
That's tough.
Mm-hmm. Like that?
Pretty rude.
Oh, of course. You want your opponent to be furious.
Yeah. I mean, it's okay. I haven't ever had a use case in the last like 15 years for a your mom joke, you know?
I think someone's on a first date and they're like, he just really wanted me to eat asparagus.
Yeah.
Have you never peed on somebody before?
Well, that's like the Ian Carmel bit where he's like, it's like really hard to bring up your like sexual kinks on a first date. So like, it's important to do it like after dinner. And before dessert, because at the very least you get a free meal out of it, you mm-hmm. know? But like, you have to find a way to time it right. Like, the waiter comes up and they're like, can I interest you guys in any dessert? And then the person you're on a date with is like, I don't think I could eat another bite. I'm stuffed. I mean, if I ate another bite, I might even barf. And then you got to be like, that would be okay. It's so good.
I feel like with golden showers, you can always ease into it during an actual shower.
Exactly.
Sure. Like, let's just try a little pee. Wash right off.
I mean, we used to...
See if you're into it.
I mean, you know, the locker room shower is every once in a while you just let one rip on somebody when they weren't paying attention. It's kind of a classic move.
That's where it all started for me.
Yep. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And then
that's
the
where
one,
I got my kink.
The one kid was like pretending to not notice. Oh no, I'm just washing my hair over here.
Oh no, now I'm jacking off. What happened? Did I fall? It's in my mouth. Oh,
why am I down here?
Yeah, it's so slippery. Anyway,
I love golden showers.
You want to let about 20 TikToks rip, and then Chris is going to talk about Steve.
Steve.
I just thought that was awesome. You guys wearing a flying squirrel suit.
Yeah, I've seen it. We have the same TikTok.
Oh, that's... It's Clifton!
We've seen this guy on the show.
Read the caption. It literally makes no sense.
When the wind also been you could as well.
Mm-hmm. That's it. That's it. And then the caption is crayons.
It is deep.
I just love that video so much. Killed me. That was Kerr-Ion. When a dad sees another dad he knows at his favorite spot.
I guess they'll let anybody in here.
Oh, God.
Yeah, you gotta wait till the end. It's
Dude, I mean, is there anything more... white Americana than
oh, God.
That
Nothing.
Fucking phrase.
Nothing.
Wow.
Excuse me, Jeff.
I just saw this
Jeff
one today.
From the Survivor Times here. Just real quick. This is your 42nd season. How on earth are you going to keep this fresh and vibrant for another year?
So here are the three variables we're going to change. First of all, the food is from Applebee's. That's big. That's emotional. That's home. That's hard to turn down.
You did it again.
Have you ever seen Monster Factory?
Uh-uh.
He's on it.
Oh, okay.
They just they play a game. Him and another guy play a game where there's big like character editors. So like Elden Ring.
Okay.
And they just make the most absurd thing.
Oh, that's
and then
awesome.
They name it and then they play the game as it.
Oh, that's sick.
Justin told me that we need to start listening to a podcast called Dungeon Daddies.
Is that the...
That sound...
It's a Dungeons and Dragons podcast.
Yeah, it could either, but it could also be another thing.
Yeah.
It's a great name for a podcast.
Super good. But yeah.
Is it because we're big D&D fans?
Yeah, I was going to say. Where are my character sheets?
I fucking hate character sheets.
So annoying. So annoying. Fucking writing up a character sheet. Blow my brains.
Hey, you had me at writing.
Shouldn't get a fucking hand. Oh, this is so good. I guess my butt is a ride for him, is the caption.
Goo goo. Gaga.
Oh, this is just so touching. I just love Jim Cummings so much.
They could go something like this, oh. But I can only do it for a small smackerel of honey.
And Tigger, don't be ridiculous. Tiggers are wonderful things.
I take my orders directly from Jafar, princess.
A women like a man with a big back porch, some kind of yeah. Woohoo!
All I want you to do is trust.
I didn't know he was the voice of Ka either.
No, he's not.
I am Duckwing Duck.
Come here, I you thought little right off.
They could go something
he
like
might have
this.
Been for like, did they make another Jungle Book?
They might have.
Because the original guy is also the guy who was Winnie the Pooh. So it makes sense
oh,
that they would have him do
hot,
it.
Oh, Anakin Hotcock.
That guy, he looked like, why can't I think of fucking Willy Wonka, the original Willy Wonka guy? Curly hair.
Gene Wilder.
The guy who did the voice looked a lot like a old school Gene Wilder.
Oh, he does.
Sterling Holloway.
Holy yeah. Buff ask. That guy's got a schnoz on him. Holy Buffett Crisk.
That's basically the only voice that guy could do, though.
Yeah.
He did it in so many movies. And
he couldn't get close enough to the fucking microphone.
There, yeah, that's definitely a very specific resonance.
Yeah.
But it's one of those voices where I was like, I don't care. Yeah. Keep doing it. It's yeah. The best.
Yeah.
But rabbit.
Hey, imagine trying to give you a hand job.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm good. I'm good.
What's with the fucking boat in the background?
I don't know. That's why I loved that video so much.
You ever notice that shit? They always got these specials about the pyramids in Egypt. They're like, oh my God, the pyramids in Egypt. Who really built them? It wasn't the Egyptians. It wasn't the Jews. It was aliens. Aliens came down and they built these pyramids. This is how you know Mexicans are the best workers in history. There are also pyramids in Mexico. Nobody questions who built those.
Wow.
There is no hour-long History Channel special. Who built the pyramids in Mexico? Mexicans, motherfucker. That's who. There was a quinceañera that needed a tent to have that shit up by Saturday. Aliens probably came and they're like, we got it. You go help the Jews. That's okay.
Dude, I know he's not everybody's favorite, but I kind of fucking love Andrew Schultz.
He's very like, I never use this word, but he is like the perfect example of like polarizing.
I was just going to say that.
Because he'll have like good jokes. He's very good at writing jokes. Yeah. Very good. But the fucking, just the weird viewpoints he has.
Yeah.
Like the whole, not all slaves were treated poorly, like that you had to treat them well because it's like owning horses and
it's fucked. But like to me, I guess to some degree, I'm like, he's got Charlemagne's respect. Like,
well, yeah, he's a black guy.
Okay. But he's got Charlemagne's respect.
Yeah. Do you they call Schulze a black guy.
I know. But just fucking the fact that like he isn't getting put on blast by people who are like notorious for doing that.
Yep.
I don't know if that's a free pass. I'm just saying, like, you know, obviously they understand his intentions are different.
That's like when Africa told me I wasn't racist.
Right. Yes. Yeah. Speaking of real quick, before we push play on this, freaking Twitter is now owned by an African American. Have you guys been seeing those hilarious posts from the QAnon people?
Yeah, it's pretty funny.
Oh my God.
Yeah, dude. It's just ostrich level head in sand. I mean, just
the dumbest people.
Like, just nuclear levels of you're a fucking idiot.
Until Hugo Weaving
Not
is behind the
point.
Wheel.
I just love everyone's like their when they think free speech, it's just like I just really want to say the N-word.
No,
like that's their idea of free speech. Like, that's it. That's the message you want
to
convey.
I don't want to be canceled for like telling people they don't have a right to exist. You know, like, I just think it's bullshit that I can't say like trans people aren't real.
Which is funny because people forget that like there are laws against hate speech. Like they
inciting violence via hate speech is a fucking crime.
Which is so funny. Like, they think that freedom of speech is the only law about speech that exists. Right. And it's like, get your shit together!
Yeah, surprisingly, there's a certain amount of depth to this.
Yeah.
To this thing.
Oh, weird. That document that's lasted for 200 years that's been amended 49 times.
It's not perfect.
Doesn't have a catch-all in there. Fucking morons.
Yeah, did you see that it's not going through?
Yeah. Well, it's...
Well, it's shaky. It's dicey.
Yeah. Like...
The deal?
Yeah.
Well, Tesla's been...
Because of the stocks and
stuff.
Yeah,
Tesla has been, how do you say, careening in value over the last two days.
Well, I feel like...
And then you'd have to... He would have to backpedal because of, like you just said, laws. Like, he would want it to be a certain way, but then he would catch some hands from some lawyers, probably.
Yeah.
Well, keeping it like that way. He doesn't have the.
I think the guys at Twitter saw, they were like, "You think we don't know how to troll? Sure, guy, try to buy the company."
Well, they're a publicly traded company, so it's very different. It's kind of fucked, actually.
For them to say,
like, when they said that they weren't gonna sell to Elon Musk, like, that's also pretty illegal, because if somebody gives a
because he's African,
right? Right, yeah, it's a whole continental thing. But it's like, if somebody gives a legitimate qualifying offer for your business, if it's publicly traded, and they don't accept an offer that would be in the best interest of the shareholders of the company,
wow,
then they're held like criminally liable for not taking that, because their primary interest is protecting the vested interest of their shareholders. So if he were to offer $200 billion, they actually can't say no.
Wow.
Which is sort of fucked, but...
That's so weird.
Yeah.
Guys, I hate to interrupt this titillating conversation.
Well, that's where like it would go to court,
sure,
basically.
Oh, but yeah.
I just got the greatest text ever.
Okay.
Do you guys remember that?
It's weird. I didn't text you, but...
That German guy that came to like our Christmas thing.
Yeah, I remember this.
No.
So, because we played...
Oh, yeah.
Was going to be at this house, but ended up doing something else.
Correct. So my brother works with him.
Yeah.
And just texts me from Tino, which is, I don't know how that's German, but so from Tino, one of the Germans in existence today. Mitt, could you may please your brother, in parentheses, tattooed one, to arrange an appointment at his studio?
That's awesome.
Oh, that's so fucking funny.
Okay, so it was unintentionally funny.
Yeah.
Mine are just amazing.
Brilliant.
Cleverly crafted.
Yes. Yes.
finely aged.
Right.
I was gonna say
like a nice wine, mm-hmm. or a cheese.
It sits there typed out for a while, and then I go over it a few times.
Just just living in the three dot bubble territory, mm-hmm. until you finally pull the trigger. I want to see this talk. This guy has a weird arm going on here. He's trying to crack an egg.
Yeah, he's squeezing an egg with his
hand. Oh, I saw this one.
I know you.
Fuck! Fucking TikTok bullshitting bastards making me do stupid shit. I like, oh, for fuck's sake! She's just passed. Oh, fuck off, man! I'm gonna get fucking kicked in when she gets home. Where the fuck? I know it when I was saying it's hiding somewhere. She'll find it and I'll get fucking shot. Where's after bastard Sheldon? There it is! Wait, that's all. Fuck off, man! What the fuck? How? How? Was that a prank? Because it worked.
That is awesome.
I mean, his accent.
So good.
Soon as I heard him say, you bastard, I was like, oh.
Oh, you bastard.
Do you ever see the...
Where's half the show gone?
Mare, have you seen that compilation of...
We watched it on the show.
The son scared in his father?
Oh, you bastard. When the son scares his dad and the dad keeps going, oh, you bastard.
Yeah,
we watched it on the show.
Good. I'm glad we did that.
So, have you seen Michael Che's new special?
No, but you know who's special? I did watch.
Elon Musk.
Brandon Schaub.
Oh, he has a new one?
New one?
Wow. Yeah.
I'm actually impressed.
What?
So bad.
So his comedy career is just like his fighting career.
Yes.
Like it just gets...
Oh, no.
My favorite comment under it...
Who greenlit another one?
He just released it on YouTube.
His theme song is that Chumbawamba song.
Dude, that first one was painful to watch.
This one is just as painful.
How?
Is that what it's called?
It's called Gringo Papi.
Yes, it's painful. I would have liked that better.
Just as painful. Yeah, really
just
bad.
As Dude, painful.
Why is
But
he...
the best comment
He's got
was,
dreams, man.
The best comment was... Wow, he left the comments on. Good for you, dude.
That is brave.
I'm just excited because on like May 5th?
Basically, every comment was some form of this open mic sucks.
I mean, the guy's gotten his face punched off. Why would some comments were like do anything to him?
It's weird because it's a 25-minute special. And
at least it's short.
He had been talking about it for so long. Like it was going to be this big thing. It's poorly recorded. The audio sucks. It's like this could have been something that Mark Norman did just for shits and giggles and would have been 10 times funnier.
Well, I'm guessing he's not like a hot commodity in that realm, right?
He's just not
to get a budget good. For something like that.
He's a great businessman.
Yeah.
Like, he could absolutely acquire
loads of money.
Yeah. But like the problem is he's not good at comedy, so
That's the kicker.
That's really too bad.
If you want to pull up YouTube, there's actually a trailer for another new special coming out. Please soon. Did you guys ever watch the 50 Tyson stuff?
What?
You just said a lot of things that didn't make any sense.
First,
so many things.
Well, the coming out please soon.
I say we watch the big titty ASMR instead.
Holy birch.
You don't want to go over the almond break?
So look up Joe List real quick.
Joe List.
I love Joe List.
I have herpes. the fact that him and...
Just type in Joe List because it'll take you to his page, and then he's got a trailer for his new special. The name of his new special is so fucking funny, I cannot wait for this to come out.
Sex is fun. I like...
This year's material is the name of his special, bro. This year's material.
Fantastic.
Sex is fun. I like breasts and sex. I look smart. I look like I'm gonna have like intellectual stuff. I'm a moron. Sorry.
Ladies and gentlemen, Joe List.
The sign was a mistake. I blew it with the sign. It's too big. kids. My wife and I, we thought about having kids during the pandemic, but then the pandemic sort of ended, and we were like, no, that's stupid. Let's not do that. And anybody, we were at home, we were like, wouldn't it be fun if we had a kid running around, but then restaurants open? We were like, we'll just go out to eat. That seems a little easier. Save a few bucks.
Oh, it comes out tomorrow, bro.
You can't hit your kids anymore. People get very upset.
April 29th.
But you know what you can do? You can throw your kids into a swimming pool as hard as you possibly can. Nobody says shit. I know that because I was at a hotel pool recently. This little kid went up to his dad. He was like, Dad, throw me in the pool. And the dad was like, you got it, son. And then the dad's whole face changed. He grabbed his son by one wrist. And he was like, ah! I saw an ad for a bra store. It said, we have 90 sizes of bras. That seems like a lot. Are there 90 breast sizes? I guess there are. I only know 4 breast sizes. I know tiny, medium, huge, and yucky. Those are the 4.
So excited.
Cool, because no one's going to believe it on YouTube. That's the problem. Every comment's going to be like, fake audience.
Yeah, he's the man.
Dude, I just realized him and Mark Norman, it's basically like Larry David and Jerry Seinfeld.
Yeah, well, they talk about that a lot, actually.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because they both were, like, obsessed with Seinfeld growing up. And then when Norman got, like, hand-picked by Jerry to, like, open for him, they both, like, were just creaming their pants for, like, 2 weeks, like, on the show, just constantly, like, so how's Jerry? He's good, man. He's good. He's really good. How about Jerry Seinfeld? Anyway, okay, the thing that you need to look up now is 50 Tyson. This guy's from the Twin Cities, actually. This guy was, like, huge. I cannot believe you guys... There he is.
This is 13 years ago.
Yeah, I know. This was huge.
Hey, this your boy 50 Tyson. Nah, same, but it's like, man, hit me up, though. My album is coming out in stores. Please, soon. Go get it up. And then it's going to be popping, though. Nah, same, but... I know you see...
Full disclosure, man, this guy might have autism.
But, oh, hold on 1 second. Before I do it, though, we make... This is my last video I'm going to make out for right now. But here we go. Yeah. You might see me all blue, all red, every day. I'm 50 Tyson. I'm from Northside Zone, Twin City, Minnesota. That's where I'm from. And I've been back. I put it on for my city, like, and ain't nothing. So we get the same. They call me 50 Tyson. I'm from the Northside Zone, Twin City, Minnesota. That's where I'm from. I ain't gonna say that I'm 50 Tyson. I'm from Northside Zone, Twin City. That's where I'm from. I ain't gonna lie, but I'm 50 Tyson. I'm from Northside Zone, Twin City, Minnesota. I ain't gonna lie, man, I'm 50 Tyson.
Okay,
I'm
from Northside
Zone, Twin City,
Minnesota. Yeah, it's not
I'm
sure.
I'm a ball player. I was born to be a ball player. I was born to be a football player. That's why I've been doing like athletic. I'm a sports my brother named Tony Jr. He's a football player.
Tony Jr.?
I'm on 4 tracks. I ain't gonna lie.
Okay, you gotta stop it. It's hurting my heart. Anyway, do you know why he made his name 50 Tyson?
Because
he looks like a cross between 50 Cent and Mike Tyson.
Oh,
a great name.
It's a great name. But yeah, we used to just like every once in a while, we just quote 50 Tyson. Like, dude, you might see me in all blue, all red every day. I'm from Northside Zone, Twin Cities, Minnesota. That's where I'm from. I was born to be a ball player. I was born to be a football player.
I'm not going to be able to find
that. That's what I've been doing, like athletic. Yeah, so anyway.
So I went to Steve's place today because...
Like Stephen Michael Pierce?
Stephen Michael Pierce.
Respect to the trans community.
It's a banger.
And fuck you, trans people.
Wait, what?
Trans people are my friends. Trans folks, go catch these hands. Trans people are my friends. So respect them for where we're waiting. Trans people are my friends. Trans folks, go catch these hands. Trans people are my friends. So respect them for where we're waiting. Trans folks, show your fucking mouth. I'll knock you out. I'll knock you out. Trans folks, show your fucking mouth. I'll knock you out. You better watch out.
Might be Canadian.
I can't tell what's going on.
It's a song.
This song is fucking lit.
So respect
Dude, the 808s on this puppy are heavy.
It's a really good beat.
It is.
It's got my favorite patch from the DX7.
Also, I kind of love the melody, like that he's using his voice to create. This is excellent.
It's very good.
Very good. Trans people love
respected friends. A trans community.
Trans folks gonna catch these hands. Trans people are my friends. That's hot.
The trans so Twitch funny. Streamer that plays hashtag, that song all the time.
Hashtag woodfuck. All right, go ahead.
Yeah, so.
You're at Steve's house.
Stephen Michael Pierce donated an old monitor that he has.
Hot.
To Mara's addict. For the addict addicts.
Where things go to get dusty. Then yelled at.
Yes.
Where things go to clutter.
But yeah, he brought up that. He was like, look, I love dad jokes. Okay? I love puns.
Mm-hmm.
But Mara last night. And then, yeah, he said the soup thing. And I was like, that's fantastic. He was like, I know. I'm like, I can't tell what your feelings are about this.
That's so funny.
Yeah, it's polarizing, I think, is what they are.
Have you ever gifted a dad joke before?
Yeah.
Isn't that the great? I had that yesterday. I did that for the first time in a while.
Mm.
Long time. Maybe my first memory of ever doing it. So it was like a really, I had a moment. My grandparents are moving in like a little over a year, and my grandpa specifically requested a gas range for their new place, like to cook on.
Where are they moving?
They're just moving into like an old people condo or something.
Oh, okay.
But they're like building these condominiums, so my grandparents get to like select some of the stuff that goes into it, right? So my grandpa's like, I really want this gas range. And my grandma was like, I don't think we've ever had a gas range before. I don't think we've ever cooked with one. And I was like, Grandpa, you know what you get to say every time you cook? And he was like, what's that? And I was like, now we're cooking with gas. And he was like, oh. Like, he was so happy. And my grandma was like, no.
Every day.
Yeah. It's just like every morning, Grandpa's going to wait. Now we're cooking with gas.
Just already downloading the DoorDash app.
Yeah.
No more home cooked meals.
I was so happy.
We're getting a microwave.
It was great.
That's my dad does that. Like he just gets so overwhelmed with joy. Like something that's really, really, really like deeply funny.
Yeah.
Like when you feel it hit in those waves of like, oh my God, it works on this level. He just goes, oh, that's so great.
Mm-hmm.
It's like I told him I got accepted into Juilliard.
Like, yeah.
Same reaction.
Well, it's like my dad has that same reaction, but it's about his own jokes. You know, like my brother one day asked what Harry Truman's middle name was, and my dad was like, Balls. And then my brother was like, what? And my dad just started howling. It's like, Harry Balls. And then my brother was like,
that's true, man.
I was asking you because I know what his middle name is. It's nothing. He doesn't have a middle name. And then my dad was like, doesn't matter. Harry Truman is now the greatest inside joke ever. He'll just like send pictures of Harry Truman to the whole family.
See, that's just
S. S Truman.
I think his middle name is literally S.
Yeah, ESS.
He could have said.
Oh, I thought it was just the.
No,
letter.
I don't know.
Oh, I think it's literally just the letter S.
It's like Homer or Jay Simpson.
Harry Truman.
Harry Truman.
Harry Truman. Hey, can I fucking toke that puppy?
Yeah.
I want to taste those fucking clouds, dude. Let me throw a little weather system out. Eh?
Yeah.
So for reference, they asked Homer on an episode what his middle name was, and he just knew it started with J. So they had a whole episode about it, and at the end, it just turned out to be J-A-Y.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, you got to watch that show.
I do. Fucking A. I was going to fucking talk about that today, but you're fucking didn't.
You're fucking didn't, man.
You didn't fucking watch the show.
Moon.
No, I know, man.
You dick ass.
I bought a whole bunch of things.
Mm-hmm.
I know. Dude.
I even did
I
a
know,
very.
You wanted to.
I did a very parent thing. Or a dad thing, I should say. Or is it a mom thing? I don't know. I was looking at candy and treats and things to watch a show.
Yes.
And there was a bag of Twix, and I was like, Landon likes Twix. I like Twix. And I grabbed the bag, and I'm like, this feels kind of light. And I look, and it says 9 ounces. And I'm like, 9 ounces? How much do the king-size candy bars weigh? And so I grabbed one of those, and it's 3 ounces. And I was like, these are a fucking dollar. I could get however many of these instead of spending $5 on the...
Nice try, Cub Foods. You got fucked again by math.
Fucking Coburn's pieces of shit. Jesus. Although I did buy the largest mango I've ever seen in my fucking life. So excited.
I love a good mango.
Is it right?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
You know, I also bought, I'd been searching for this vegetable for so long. And I completely forgot to even look at what they were called.
Daikon.
Huh? They're radishes in the shape of carrots.
Daikon. Oh, parsnip.
Is that what that is?
Yeah.
Yeah, parsnip.
Big white.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Holy shit. Nice pull.
Thank you.
Very white.
That was the dumbest explanation of a parsnip ever. They're radishes in the shape of carrots?
They are.
Radishes are red, you Nimrod.
I said all white, okay?
I know.
Don't you fucking...
Because
I was peeling them and I was like, oh yeah, that's why I like these things, because they're just huge fucking
pulses.
They taste exactly like radishes.
Oh, I always thought parsnips tasted, they're kind of like a good replacement for potatoes because they're so starchy.
Yeah, you know, I'll have to have you take a sniff after this. Hey, take a sniff of my parsnips.
Holy cow.
What's going on here?
Look at the
a daikon.
Look at the cleave on that chick, huh?
A daikon?
Hey. Daikon.
Oh.
Is also a radish.
Oh. Okay.
It's also this cartoon that I was actually looking at on TikTok. And it had this fucking banger of a song. I'm like, is this just some random Japanese song? No, it was Electric Light Orchestra.
ELO?
Yeah, a little song called Twilight. Very good song.
Mm. I don't know. Is it on, which one is it on? Which album is it on, I should say?
Here you go, dude. Thank you.
You felk.
I'm from Northside Zone. Twins. Twins. That's where I'm from. Oh, yeah. This song bangs. This is so 80s. So 80s. Also very ELO to just have like the peppiest tempo. I still think Telephone Line by them is not only my favorite song by them, I think it's a top 10 song of all time.
So I have a question for single people.
Let her buck.
Why are y'all's living spaces so dark all the time? Like, if you're a single person, you live by yourself. I noticed this because...
energy conservation, maybe?
Autism?
Ooh. Oh, man. Is everyone...
Social anxiety?
I don't know. But I started to think about it because...
Self-loathing?
Because Steve's place had no lights on, just his computer screens. And I was like, dude, how can you see?
You want to highlight the dust?
It just doesn't... I mean, you know your place, you know? So there, you don't need all the lights on. You don't need... You know where everything is.
Everyone should be afraid of the dark.
Sure. I will say the only time I'm truly afraid of the dark and not ashamed to admit it at all is when you turn the lights off in the basement.
Ugh.
And you have to go up the stairs.
I'm always just mad at the dark because I'm not scared of it.
Oh, yeah, right.
I'm in bed and I'm just like, it would be so fucking sick if there was a monster. And I like, if I turn around and like I picture it in my head and I turn and I'm like, it's just nothing.
You're just ready.
Why don't I see ghosts?
I wish I had that attitude. You know what I did?
It's a ghost. Go ahead.
Last night I had to get something out of the utility room, and for whatever reason, as I'm opening the door, I go like this. I cocked my fist back as though something was in the dark waiting for me.
Sometimes you gotta be prepared, dude. I've been there.
But also, how funny would it be if there was a monster and he was like, whoa!
Easy, guy.
I didn't know you were throwing hands.
Yeah, I'm ethereal, but this come on. Well, the last fucking however many weeks, Kirby's been having to go outside and shit in the middle of the night. I figured out what the problem is, though.
Mm.
It's every day that he goes to the park and he drinks a bunch of that fucking mud water at the park. Ooh. Then he has these mud poops, which are very hard and filled with sediment, and he needs to get them out of his body. But he always poops so many times, and then he builds up a mud poop, and then he's got to get rid of it in the middle of the night because he can't keep sleeping because he's got a fucking rock-hard turd in his anus.
Yeah.
Right in that dog colon. But last night, we ran into the same issue. I fucking brought him outside, and I'm going full fucking Arnold in Predator.
Oh,
there,
yeah.
Because I swear to Christ, this is not an exaggeration. Sometimes you see 2, 3, 4 deer at once, right? I mean,
oh,
that's
yeah.
pretty normal, right? A handful of deer. And you're like, wow, this is a family of deer. I saw 13 deer at once.
It's like the Ring 2.
Well, like the fucking, the backdrop of the world in like the amount of light that we had was moving. And I'm like, something's happening, you know? Kirby's all fucking jacked up, and I'm like, dude, you just got to drop a nuke. Like, well, let's just take a shit, get the fuck back inside, you know? And he's sniffing around, and then we hear the crunching underfoot, and I'm like, damn it, dude. Like, he's going to go fucking bananas. And then, like, 15 feet away from us, I just, like, whoop, and I see these two, like, the eyes, because there's, like, a street light behind her. And I'm like, oh, they're right there. Hey, Kirby. Dad has to shit now. But then he was like, he immediately went from like, I'm going to protect, you know, against a predator to like, oh, friends.
Yeah,
and
oh,
then,
yeah, yeah.
And
yeah.
then it was like, well, now I'm not going to get you to shit at all. So I just like, I was outside with him last night for 25 minutes at 2 a.m.
I hate that.
Well, and Caitlin wakes me up. She's like, can you take him outside? He was just trying to bite me when we were out there. And I'm like, you probably had him out there for 3 fucking seconds. What movie is this lady in?
The Ring 2. This is one of the most interesting decisions in filmmaking history. Rachel!
Do you think, like, for that lady's, you know, resume... I don't know what they call it in the acting world. They're like, okay, says you know how to play piano, and look exactly like Nicole Kidman.
Maybe.
So you never saw The Ring 2?
I never saw The Ring.
I saw a little bit of The Ring, but so I had never seen this, but like around the time when this came out, a friend and I are driving to Powder Ridge, and we like, have you been to Kimball, like around that area? So like those back roads, there's like just random like hills, right? So we go around a bend, and on one of those random hills, all deer, the whole fucking field. And I was like, dude, that is the most deer I've ever seen in my life. But he was freaking out because he was like, it's just like The Ring 2, man. I'm like, what?
Was he freaked out?
I don't know, because we were...
It hits different in the theater, too. That looks way worse in the theater.
Oh, yeah.
It already looks ass, but like blown up.
I mean, it makes
CG deer. Oh, fucking A, man. 2005.
It makes me uncomfortable.
I never. Is that the You're Gonna Die in 7 Days?
Yeah, the videotape.
Yeah. I don't.
So, wait, I thought they destroyed the tape in the first one.
It's a horror movie. They just make up whatever they want.
I have no idea.
She's not up here.
Is she outside, Mom? Did any of those piece of shit kids let her out?
Oh, child abuse.
Oh my God, she's going to find Ashi and she's just going to be licking her lips and there will be blood all over her face. I had sushi for dinner.
Gross.
Turns out I'm gay because I love me some pussy. Cat.
I forgot to tell you, Mara. I texted Alex last night immediately because it was so fucking funny.
This is funny.
So sushi is in the bathroom downstairs, cause it's, you know, nice and big. And, Kim and I went down to go play with, sushi and the door was locked and Kim's like, Landon. He's like, yeah, what are you doing in there? I'm pooping. Well, what's sushi doing? Being used as toilet paper. Like without skipping a beat. All right.
Probably one of the worst years in cinema history, 2005.
A lot of bad shit.
War of the Worlds. Just Friends.
War of the Worlds did make me cry, though, because...
Be cool. Wait, waiting.
Oh, God, was Waiting bad.
Robots. Ring 2. Except for 40-Year-Old Virgin kind of made up for it.
That was a pretty good movie.
But that War of the Worlds, right?
Mm-hmm.
Not very good. Although we did get to drive through the set of where the plane crash scene was. And did you know they bought an actual plane and like ripped it apart just for that scene?
That doesn't shock me.
It's fucking crazy.
It definitely had a budget.
Yeah, big time.
God, that movie
looked
was,
like an expensive
movie.
The movie
was so weird.
Yeah, I didn't like it.
Like so, the whole kicking off like the impending doom of humanity by playing catch with your son thing.
Yeah.
So fucked.
The one thing that got me, though, right, was when the Scientologist guy and his two kids are, like, on that hill,
mm-hmm.
and the son is like, I'm going to go fight. And he's like, don't fucking leave. But they got separated from the daughter.
Yeah.
And the son is like, you got to choose. And it's like, oh, my fucking God. I remember... like saying that to my dad, and he was like, oh, I'd punch you in the face, knock you out, throw you over my shoulder, and then he'd go.
Because he like sister. Runs over a hill and it's like fire erupts from that yeah, side. Yeah. Dude. Immediately as he runs over the hill.
Yeah, he died.
No, he was fine.
I know. It's just like you have that moment oh, when yeah. it happens where you're like, oh, son's dead. All right. Well, mom was going to Boston.
Still not as bad as A Quiet Place, though.
Tears wise or bad wise? Because I heard A Quiet Place was very good.
You haven't seen it?
No.
Oh, I was about to spoil the shit out of something.
Yeah, I'm a hipster.
Do you think they go along with it, so Quietest Place for the third, or do they go subvert expectations, like The Loudest Place?
That'd be hilarious.
Everyone's just playing kazoos. They hate this.
They're just going to band practice for the Bikini Bottom Band.
It's called Laugh, but it's spelled L-A-F, loud as fuck.
Nice. No, you can spoil it for me. It came out 14 fucking years ago or whatever, so I don't... I just went full hipster. Everybody was like, dude, John Krasinski is now an action horror star and has great triceps.
And then like 10 seconds later, he's like an FBI shill.
Yeah, and everyone was like, CIA. Also, the fact that he like did the movie with his real wife, Emily Blunt, is like, that's like really cool. And I'm like...
Well, and they learned ASL, like... like there's so many components of it's this Luth.
Yeah.
There's so many components of that production that you're just like solidifies what a good human being John Krasinski is.
Well, is he though? I don't know. Do you know?
Yeah. In my soul.
Okay.
Anyways.
He's part of MK Ultra, so it's best not to pay
God,
attention to
him. I bet he is.
Because he's now the Air Force One guy that Harrison Ford used to be.
Jack Ryan?
Jack Ryan, yeah.
Wow, well done.
And then like in interviews, he's like, man, the CIA is pretty much the best organization that's ever existed.
Yeah, like, yeah, Gulf of Tonkin, yeah.
And he's kind of looking off
did you
to
watch?
The side, like, yep.
Did you watch the series?
Yeah, Bay Pigs. Yeah, Bay Pigs.
No, I'm saying, did either of you watch his Jack Ryan run?
No.
Is it good?
It shows how fucking horrible the CIA is.
Oh, that's good. Because they are.
Because at one point they have
to... Fucking rogue organization that has just killed so many people.
They
destroyed countries.
We don't like your government.
Millions of lives.
They induct or... what would you say? They get the help of somebody who is a sex trafficker. And John Krasinski's like, what? What are we doing? And he's like, hey, man, I need you to calm the fuck down, okay? We need this guy to get this information. And he's like,
we need this guy to get this information. Also, this guy needs some 12-year-olds, so get on it.
So fucked. Yeah. So
yeah, I don't know, man. Hey, the thing that kind of turned me off about the old J. Kraz was when he did like the good news thing during COVID, you know, and then he sold it.
I thought you loved that.
I was kind of happy about it for a minute, and then he sold it.
Who has it now?
I think NBC bought it.
for, like, do they do anything with it, though?
They just bought it because they were like, hey, here's a way to make more money during the old everybody's inside. But then good old Cody Johnst gave me a little added perspective when I was watching one of the Some More News things about, like, the whole COVID and everything and how, like, yeah, of course, like, an unfathomably rich and totally well off and, like, very safe and healthy and has to worry about nothing person is giving us, here's the good news.
Yeah, hey, look, it's not all bad. It's just right. Okay.
Yeah, like, that to me, I'm like, all right, that's actually kind of a hot take to be like, yeah, of course the celebrities in our lives are like, life could be worse, you know, like, for reals. And you're like, yeah, life is worse for about 99% of people.
But yeah, it's like Pelosi was on TV like, well, here's my, she's basically a dragon that hoards ice cream.
Oh, my
she's
God.
Like, here's my ice creams from around the world.
Well, she is the
It's not bad being inside.
She is the Smaug of the Senate.
Exactly, yeah.
Fucking.
But Krasinski's thing was the fact that everybody was just being bombarded with the most depressing shit
every
day. Yeah,
so like
day.
To some degree, you're like, all right, I get that. You know, that's awesome. Because
what else is he going to do? That's his career.
Yeah, but like, what else could he do? I mean, he could...
but we don't know if he wasn't doing anything.
Sure, but what else could he do? More publicly, I don't know, denounce, you know, atrocities committed by some of the very companies he has worked for. And
such as?
The National Broadcasting Corporation, for example.
What have they done?
NBC?
Yeah.
Like, employed and... then silenced the victims of the person they employed who committed massive atrocities and then only fired him when the people found out?
You're talking about my favorite Pusha, one of my favorite Pusha T lines. Good morning, Matt Lauer. Can I live?
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. Yeah. So there's that. I don't know. I mean...
WNBC.
Like constantly profiting off of the atrocities of the world by pushing narratives and using.
But you know what is a great example of that, though? That's like when somebody yelled at us for not talking about Black Lives Matter and making silly jokes in a clip for our show.
Sure. But we're not profiting.
I was gonna say, let me check my bank account.
Off of talking about Black Lives Matter. We're not sending people around the world to investigate and shed light on the atrocities that are happening around
the
world.
I get what you're saying.
In order to essentially make more money and do nothing to fix said atrocities. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, hey, send a guy to fucking wherever to report on what's happening, but then maybe throw some of that $30 billion you made last year at the problem. You know?
I wonder if they do.
Maybe they do. I don't care. I'm ranting.
But that made me think of John Oliver.
Yeah.
Like, he has just embarrassed the ever-living shit out of all journalists. I don't think I've ever seen someone like genuinely make change happen because of a segment they did. Like journalists think that they're like shedding light and changing the world. John Oliver is shitting on these people and making a change.
Right. That's where I'm like, there's value in that, you know, like it to do an entire or focus like your main story of a show on debt buying and how debt buying is just like mostly buying people's medical debt and then taking them to court over it and ruining people's lives. So they were offered by signing up for this like service where it's like they sign their team up for this service that like sells giant clumps of people's debt for like pennies on the dollar.
Oh, I remember the
segment. So they bought a package of it and then just forgave it. It was like $18 million in medical debt. And they were just like, it's the biggest giveaway ever on TV. We're just going to say, fuck you, and push this button. And now all your debt's gone.
Didn't they start a site That's the other funny thing is they'll start...
Dude, when they buy those websites, dude, that gets me every time.
But I thought... I could be thinking of a different segment, but I thought they started one where you could donate to a thing and that would go towards forgiving people's debts or something.
Probably. Well, they like... I mean, I don't know. They do stuff like that all the time, though. Like, with, they do that Slap Suits episode about... Bob Murray, who's like the coal miner executive, like he's the largest private owner of coal mines in the United States, and John Oliver did like a whole segment on coal mining and basically shit on Bob Murray like the whole time, and they had like a guy in a squirrel costume like come out because he said that a squirrel told him to get into coal mining, so fucking weird. And then. They also like mocked him with like he, in order to like, give extra compensation to his workers for like working in extremely, extremely, unsafe conditions, he like created this sort of, like incentive sort of bonus program where like they were paid more for like extracting a certain amount over their quota of coal. And, like this guy, like all these workers were like, fucking no, we don't want it. We just want to be safe. Like we're in a coal mine. It's like notoriously one of the most dangerous jobs in the world. And the company like went ahead with it anyway. And they started sending out these bonus checks to people. And this guy got a check for like $3.41 of a bonus. And the guy returned it with like a void on it. And then he wrote "Eat shit, Bob" on the check. So they have this guy in a squirrel costume come out with like a giant check and he goes, "It's made out to eat shit, Bob." And then Bob Murray filed a slap lawsuit, which is like, it's basically like a phony lawsuit. Trump has done dozens of these, but it's a phony lawsuit to silence people, basically. Oh. So like you just take somebody to court for like libel, which is like not, it's that you have no real case, but you get them all tied up and you essentially drain them of all their finances for all the legal costs. So he filed a lawsuit against last week tonight, and they ended up winning the lawsuit against him. So then he did a whole Slap Suits episode, and I promise this is coming full circle to the buying the websites thing, because one of their big things in the lawsuit was that they wanted them to take down that segment. And like take it off the internet, whatever. And John says, like, it's still on the internet, big time. And you can find it at stillontheinternetbigtime.com. Like, literally bought the domain stillontheinternetbigtime.com and fucking just have that clip there. It's great. Yeah, they just, I don't know. I love like the whole, they'll say something on the show and they'll like throw a hashtag underneath, like, for whatever then it'll immediately be trending on Twitter. And like it gets the word out about stuff, but then they like actually make changes in people's lives. Like,
speaking of Twitter, let's do this.
Yes, the most followed people on Twitter.
This guy's number one.
Is he really?
Yes.
Fucking why? Just because people forgot to
follow
after the presidency ended?
We love this man. Okay, he's good also African American.
Okay? He proved it,
which we. Nice. He's Hawaiian American.
Elon Musk is more African.
He committed some atrocities and didn't do all the things that he said he was going to do. But
he
also
did it while sounding great.
Right.
Silver tongue on this guy.
I will say that I never felt more unified in my life politically, like, which is probably not the best thing ever, because like the fact that everyone was like,
burning effigies.
The man, everyone's like, man, our president could hit a jump shot. We are just
that's so tight. Yeah.
You know, like, we're good, life's good,
so fucking tight, dude.
But he did do a pretty good job of steering us out of like one of the most horrifying financial tragedies
and then right back into another one.
That one wasn't his fault though. Wait, which one are you talking about?
You don't think like those kind of politics led to like a backlash?
Oh, no, no, because like COVID is the cause of a lot of the financial hardship we've been having now.
And well, why was COVID a problem?
Well, he he had a lot of stuff put in place to be able to protect us against a global pandemic. And then Trump immediately upon entering office dismantled all of those things.
Yeah, I know, but like Trump just doesn't come out of nowhere.
Sure.
Oh, you think that?
Sure, but I think it was more like stoked by the people who stood to profit off of the fear mongering that they created because a black guy was president.
Some of that, but not everybody.
Sure. Are you pointing towards like the sort of
we're going to change everything and then nothing. Right, yeah. And it's like, well, why the fuck would I vote for any politicians anymore?
Yeah,
we're
going to
vote
created,
for the guy.
He created apathy, yeah. Which like in turn, yes, created, you know.
Because he had some power and
it opened a
window. Didn't really use it.
Yeah. I will say that he was blocked at every corner and every turn.
Yeah, but it was like, there are things that you can do. Yeah. Like he was just kind of like, oh, here's Merrick Garland. And then they're like, nah. And he's like, okay. Yeah. He could have just been like, all right, here's the next person. Yeah. Here's the next person.
Sure.
Yeah. He could have filled some judges' positions.
Sure. Well, yeah.
But he did fight for, I mean, not to like.
Healthcare ended up being a Republican program.
Yeah. But well, as far as like.
Boy, did it ever.
Mm-hmm.
Like LGBTQ stuff, this guy was like the most vocal president we've had. And Trump had all of the opportunity to go, okay, so people like when you're pro LGBTQ, got it. But went the other way. So like this guy knew that within his own, like, you know,
well, both of them captured a different segment of the disenfranchised voters of America.
Very well said.
One of them captured the, people who were feeling let down by their government.
Yeah.
And the other one captured people who were feeling things weren't as good as they used to be.
I was going to say, whites aren't on tap anymore?
Right. And it just so happens that there are a lot more of those folks than we thought.
Yeah. There's some level of insanity that goes along with wanting to be the president.
Yeah.
Because along the way,
psychopathy.
You learn that you have little to no genuine control over anything.
And you're like, vote for me.
You're the poster boy and the scapegoat. And Obama even said, because somebody was one of his security guards or whatever. Bodyguards. I don't know. Whatever. One of his security.
Secret Service.
There we go.
Fucking.
Why I couldn't. My brain just did a dump. But was talking with him before he was out of office and was like, I forget where I saw this, but he was like, I just did the thing that we've all wanted to do. He was like, so, I mean, are aliens real? Or like was asking him all the insane questions that we think the president knows. And Obama's like, you want me to be honest? They tell me like 30% of all of the things that are actually going on.
That's so fucked.
Most of it's just really boring.
Yeah. So.
Yeah, the Jews are at it again.
So like imagine you're.
Might want to believe that. That seemed really genuine. I didn't mean that genuinely. That's...
Jews are uppity. What can you do? But imagine you become one of the most known people on the planet and what is viewed as...
The most known person on the planet.
What is viewed as the most powerful person, right?
Right.
But then somebody goes, oh, you're not cleared to know this.
Right. Yeah. There's like 60,000 people that are like, he doesn't have the cred. Can't do it. He can't handle
it. Bonkers.
Yeah, there's a secretary in New Mexico that's like, no. Hey, it's the president. Should I patch him through or just send him to voicemail? Send him to the shitty voicemail. Next.
Piece of garbage. Why you no do?
Oh, you did you click it individually? And then it's just not... Sucking or
it
bucket?
Should go to
there. We go now. We're
yeah. Okay. The Biebs.
Oh,
So Justin Bieber.
Can you zoom a tad? I can't even really see him. There he is. Look at that hunk.
Yeah. So
an old photo.
Is it?
Might I can tell by his hair.
Oh yeah, you're right. But yeah, I learned that for the last, I don't know, for a long time, he's done a ton of work with children's hospitals.
Yeah, he's like I think he kind of turned his shit around after like pissing on his neighbor's house or something, whatever he did.
But it was like ever since he was like genuinely a kid. So before people like thought that he was this spoiled whatever, or like
piece of chit.
So and he never stopped.
Yeah.
So like just like last week when I was saying like I tried to find the good in the people that get the most shit talked on them.
Yeah.
He's one that like I don't think he deserves the erroneous amount
the
of
ungodly
hate
amount of hate that he gets. Yeah. He's like Ben Shapiro, you know?
Also doesn't deserve this many Twitter followers once again.
Yeah.
Yeah. But at least this one's to be expected.
If there
right?
isn't a meme account in this list, I'm gonna be furious.
Is that how people follow? They're just like, I like this thing.
Yeah.
And then
I've been
but like it's Beatlemania, right?
Yeah.
It's the whole boy band thing. Like, that one makes sense. Mm-hmm. Versus it being, you know, some political thing. They're just like, he's hot. I want to see his 17-year-old dick.
I saw a meme on one of the meme accounts I follow. It's somebody posted on Facebook. It says, got called racist at a McDonald's today. And the top comment is, tell us what happened, lad. And then they said, I got called racist in a McDonald's. And then the person said, yeah, but why? And they said, I was being racist. It fucking killed me, dude.
Oh, and also, I want to see your 17-year-old dick or whatever. That'll be allowed on Elon's Twitter.
Oof.
That won't get banned.
Very true.
So, hell yeah.
Damn.
Sexual
they're
predators.
Just words, guys.
Free speech, baby.
free speech, also free kids.
Oh, it's Katy Perry.
Katy motherfucking Perry.
Is that who that is?
Yeah,
it says it on the screen.
She changes
can't see that
her thing. Look so much.
She does. She's got this sort of Madonna.
It's wild
thing
but
on.
I forgot that she's married to fucking Orlando Bloom.
Yeah, she is married to Orlando.
And my God, is that man hot?
I named my latest Elden Ring character Katy Perry.
Really?
She is also hot.
Yeah.
She had that song called like Birthday or whatever, the big balloons or whatever, and this is the music video for that is
California Girls. That music video where she's got fucking fireworks coming out of her tits?
Yeah.
But it's Katy Perry.
Perry.
Oh, nice. That's funny.
Yeah.
But yeah, she's just, I don't know. She's a smidge on the problematic side.
Yeah. Probably should start calling her Katy Perry tits. You know what I mean? That's stupid.
But she's got
The top like photo on Google? Like,
no, I just.
How did we do this?
I just thought this one was funny.
Okay. Is that a real dog?
Because it looks like she was shocked. Like, oh no,
fake
my phone.
Shocked, yeah.
You know, yeah. But cute fucking dog.
Real or not?
It's a real dog.
It's very docile.
Yeah. Looks just like my mom's dog, Charles. Rihanna.
She's really good
in
battleship.
She's got a really punchable face, don't you think?
It's a hate crime.
Yeah. This is a jerk.
Very good.
Thank you.
For listeners, if you don't get it, fucking Google it.
I mean, V attractive. I think she brought on top three worst eras of music, though.
That's funny.
The early 10s.
Ponda Replay was the start of a real tough era for music. That was her first big hit. Do you guys remember that song?
Oh, yeah.
I was listening to Gojira.
Yeah, because you have good taste.
Yeah, I know. I'm rad as fuck. I don't know.
You have your shit together. I'm not saying America does.
Yeah, I abandoned that shit in high school.
I turned Gojira on at the shop,
mm-hmm.
and John goes, dude, I fucking love the sound of whales.
Who doesn't?
But yeah.
Probably some asshole whales are like,
just
fucking shut up.
monster badass.
Yeah.
I'm like, she okay, to fuck Jay-Z and live to tell the tale.
Wow. Hot
take. You know what I mean?
Yeah, sure. Hot take.
She's
good looking. I mean, she's very good looking. She's a very talented vocalist.
And she's funny.
She is funny. She's done a lot, from what I understand, for like small, like fashion designers. Has given some exposure to people who don't have a lot of it, which I think is pretty cool.
Yeah.
She's not pulling a Lady Gaga and like wearing meat, you know, which fucking oops on that one. I don't mind Lady Gaga. I just think that, you know, by the end of the night, you smell terrible.
Yeah.
Which probably the point. So my bad. I'm gonna punch out now.
What's your favorite Rihanna tweet?
Rihanna tweet?
Mm-hmm.
When somebody was hating on her small boobs, and she posted a photo of her giving the double bird, covering her nips.
I don't know that I've ever actually seen a Rihanna tweet.
So. That's right. That's what I was getting
at. I'm in a very different hallway on Twitter.
I was impressed that you knew it.
I totally made that up.
Oh, okay.
Cristiano Ronaldo!
Okay, moving on.
We already know. Taylor
moving on.
Swift. Can we, for just a second?
Sure.
I hate that we're not allowed to hate this lady. I fucking hate her.
As do I, but my wife is obsessed with her, so I can't.
So,
isn't your wife also obsessed with her?
Yes.
God, it's irritating.
So her entire career, especially as a pop artist, has been record after record shitting on every boyfriend she's ever had.
Mm-hmm.
And then they just have to go, like Jake Gyllenhaal for 10 years has had to deal with this shit. And it's like,
is Jake Gyllenhaal like not allowed to make records?
What
he could release his own record. About,
I know,
Taylor
but
Swift.
Like to some degree, like
her. Which, I don't know what her fans are called, but they won't watch anything that he's done. It's like
they literally like have boycotted him.
Yeah,
and also, how petty does he look if he comes out with a diss track afterwards?
Hilarious. I don't know. I might follow him on Twitter.
To you, because you're based as shit. But I'm talking about the people who are easily swayed by somebody going, Jake Gyllenhaal broke my heart. And everyone's like, oh my God.
Are they not
sick? You know she writes this on her own?
Yeah, they don't see a pattern where like it's every song is about
every
some
song,
relationship
every
she
song.
Had that ended. It's like, wow, you sure are in a lot of shitty relationships.
Oh, yeah,
like, there's a common denominator
here.
Yeah,
at some point, you're the problem, Taylor.
That'll be the last album. That
I
was
can't
me.
Fucking stand Taylor Swift, dude.
Yeah.
And also, everybody...
It's not you, it's me. That's the last album she wrote.
God, I hope so. But like, you know, for all the people that are like, you're shitting on somebody who actually does a lot of the, you know, blah, blah, blah. Like, I don't give a fuck, but... Beck doesn't get this kind of love. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, I wonder how you go about that.
Like, did Steely Dan get this kind of love?
Sure, yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, there's what...
The Grateful Dead did.
Yeah, but the Grateful Dead had a following that was like...
Zombies.
So much more based around, like, the environment they created for people to appreciate their music.
So if the Swift fans did more drugs, you'd say they'd be a lot better.
Maybe, or like maybe if Taylor Swift didn't just like do the XL Energy Center twice.
That's
a year.
The thing. That's what it is. So perfect examples, the Grateful Dead, they were not like vengeful and vindictive. Like her fans, they like dissect a song, go, who the fuck did she write this about?
Yes.
And then they attack that person.
They're all the crazy girlfriend meme or whatever.
Yes. It's
like the big eyes.
Yeah.
In like 2007.
Yeah.
Well, and like,
and she doesn't stop them. She's not like,
no,
guys,
exactly.
Easy.
She's like profiting off.
I was gonna say she has a whole bathtub full of jewelry,
full
so.
Of cash.
And then her tweets must suck ass.
Yeah.
Just the worst.
Oh God, I bet they
toilet
are.
Account.
Oh, and also, fuck way, like. Get out of my area code with the I'm gonna come out with a documentary dedicated to the album that I just came out with that is a re-release of a previously released album. Holy.
Wasn't it re-recorded, though? It had to be.
It had to be, yeah. Because she didn't get, like, she's finally getting royalties for it or whatever.
By the way, this is not us being insensitive. Being sexually harassed by your fucking producer, that's a nightmare.
Yeah, that's
horrible.
That sucks horn. Well.
Did she write a song about
poor
that?
Poor choice of words.
I think so.
Well, that's
yeah,
good.
Probably, but. Also, like, it just, I mean, the amount of hubris you have to have and the amount of, like, just to think, like, I just get this vibe that she thinks she's an amazing human being. And I'm like.
Metallica did that.
Yes.
That was a really good movie, too.
Yes, they did. Well, I mean, I love Dave Grohl, but that guy loves making documentaries about himself. So even though he's. Like,
but it's not always about him. It's about like the origins of the music he's making.
That's
it's
true.
Not like following him waking up in the morning.
That's
being
true.
Like, another day on tour. Gonna make another $350,000 tonight. Ugh.
Better tweet some inane
God,
bullshit.
Where's my ex Benny?
That's very true.
Carol, where's my ex Benny? Bitch. Cool. She's cool. All right, next. Oh, that was supposed to be like a.
I was taking a gulp.
I should have said thank you next. I'm fucking idiot. Hey, look, it's the meat lady.
Yeah.
But do you think good Twitter?
I believe so, actually. I'm fairly confident she's...
She might be kind of based.
Yeah.
It seems like something she'd do.
Now, Lady Gaga...
So far up her
always
own
pisses
ass.
Me off.
So far up her own ass.
Well, okay, so she, for a minute, was like... Fuck the music industry and what it's doing to people's souls, and like went on this just great like mission to try and fix shit, was doing tours and giving talks. And then I think she wasn't making money. And so she was like, I'm going to go back to selling out, I guess. And just like went back on everything she fucking said ever.
Well, yeah, that's capitalism.
Very upsetting.
I have an irrational reason for hating her.
Oh, God, let her rip, please.
So my friend saw that movie where she was like a country singer.
Yeah, what's that called?
With Bradley Cooper.
A Star Is Born?
A Star Is Born. There we go.
Haven't seen it. Does Adam Sandler get shot in the face?
I hope so. We were talking about it. I'm like, oh, is it any good? And they're like, yeah, it was so good. And then one of them was like, you know, you kind of look like Lady Gaga. And then the other one agreed. And then I was like, no, I fucking do not. And it makes me angry every time I see her because I do not.
I get what they probably see.
I feel like you have more of a John Leguizamo vibe.
Yeah. Exactly. That's exactly where my mind goes to. I'm just like, I don't need to hear this. It pisses me off.
It's like a, I don't know.
I have mirrors.
Yeah, but you also have body dysmorphia. So when you look in a mirror, you see John Candy, and none of us see that.
Are you playing a saxophone? Because if so, I want some of that.
Anyways,
shitty tweets. Get out of the fucking game.
Robert Downey Jr.
Forgot about
him. Can we play that, just that clip, the Jericho clip? Because it's like one of my favorite clips and or moments in any of the Marvel movies.
It's pretty good
by a long shot,
but super weird too, because
I
didn't know that he was even active on social media.
What happened?
Robert Downey
Jr. Just
look
up Iron Man Jericho. Do you know how to spell Jericho? Of course you do.
A wrestler name.
Yeah, that's why. My God. Oh God, do you think he has to unroll his dick when he takes it out of his pants? Peace. That's it. That's all I got.
You think his beard is all makeup?
God, I hope so. But
phone was
that scene
giving me vibes.
But yeah, I think RDJ. I like his comeback story.
Yeah, dude, he had a tough, like a really tough bounce there.
Yeah.
For a while.
And the respect that he gave to his wife.
This is like the rebound, right?
Yeah.
Iron Man.
Yeah.
This was like the first movie back, I think. Or the first, like, major motion picture.
Yeah.
Back.
Yes,
yeah.
There you go. Yeah, for sure.
I mean...
And then everyone was like, man, maybe these Marvel movies aren't going to suck ass.
Well, and they took such a leap of faith on him, too. But, like, he is the perfect person to play Tony Stark.
Well, and the fact that he threw in the line that everyone remembers?
I am Iron Man.
I am Iron Man.
Yeah, like that's fucking great. And yeah.
God. You guys got a preview. I didn't see it.
Oh, oh, that's funny.
It's you're not going to be thrilled.
Boom. Who's that?
That's Justin Bieber again.
I was just going to say it's Justin Bieber.
Time shifted.
Ellen. I mean, whatever.
I've just heard so many horrible things about them.
I liked her comedy special like 20 years ago.
Yeah.
Excellent. So good. Also, way before they became what they are now.
Even, wait, is she going by them theys now?
I thought she was she, her, they, them, but I could be wrong. Also, it's
not
disrespectful to just use they.
That's true. Very good point.
Which I'm working on.
So the last special they did was very funny because they made fun of like rich comedians trying to be like
It's relatable. Called, the special's called Relatable.
Yeah. So fucking funny.
I thought it was okay. That original special, though, the one that got her the Ellen DeGeneres show, is arguably one of the greatest HBO specials ever.
Yeah.
I mean, the phone call with God is... it's
good tweeter? Probably not.
No, no. Self-righteous as fuck.
Yeah.
Although...
I know who the next guy is. Do you know who the next person is?
I looked up a clip of her. I was like, I wonder, did she ever cry on Ellen on her own show? I love watching hosts cry on their own show.
You should watch the Kelly Clarkson show then.
Ooh.
My God.
I didn't even know that existed.
Yeah, I forget that it exists. Because is it on an actual network or is it a web series?
I think it's on a network. And honestly, I can get behind Kelly Clarkson.
Yeah.
I don't mind her.
Me either. She covered a Post Malone song at one of her shows.
That's fucking rad.
Super sick. But she got wildly upset because she had,
an intern got her the wrong coffee.
She had helped somebody, foster this dog. And then something happened where the dog had to be put down and she was just like a wreck because the family was so bummed. Like, so she was like, in her mind, she was like, oh, I gave you a dog to watch die. Like, and she just like sobbing uncontrollably on her show. And it's like, holy fuck, you do have human side.
Oh. Well, her wife is.
That's just how pets work, though. I can't wait to see you. It's a Louis C.K. bit.
Yeah. Ah.
I bought us being sad in a few years.
Can't wait to watch you die slowly.
But
Sarah Silverman does a bit about that too.
Really?
Yeah, where she's like, my dog, I had to put my dog down, but I got a new dog. And I just feel like I should put it down. Because I just don't want to go through that again. It's so funny.
Who's the next one?
Modi.
Yeah. President of India?
India.
Yeah.
Not a good guy.
Yeah.
This one makes so much. There's just a ton of people there.
That's what I was trying to figure out. Is it just all people of India following him?
Probably.
Like when you sign up for MySpace.
Yeah, this guy's this guy's pretty fucked. Does some really not cool stuff around the LGBTQ community.
Yeah.
Pretty bad guy.
Like, but I tried finding like bad photos of him.
There isn't one.
Don't exist.
Guy's photogenic as hell.
Yeah. It's like, you look like the most peaceful dude in the world, but why are all of these articles like...
I mean, there's a lot of IT people out there just scrubbing the internet of these bad photos.
Nice.
Ah!
A lot of customer service.
Do you think he ever is like, I'm going to do it? And they're like, don't. He's like, I'm going to do it. And then he puts on a headset. Thank you for calling. And they're like, blah!
Thank you for calling Comcast. This is Modi. The gays don't deserve rights. I may help you today. Okay.
No, he's like when they give you to the next level, he's the top level.
Yeah. Can I speak to your manager? You could speak to my president.
I'm the last line before you get Modi.
And that was it.
We went from political.
Exactly. I was going to say
circle
starts with
suck
the president.
It, India.
ends with president.
Your president is barely in the top 10.
But yeah.
He's a bad dude.
Yeah.
That just says something about us as Americans.
Oh, yeah. We're awful people. But
yeah.
I think maybe
I ate a McChicken today. I committed to massive, massive human rights or animal rights problems.
But maybe that's why Obama's so high, is everyone's like, I gotta put someone in here that makes me look not like a piece of shit.
Sure, yeah.
I have
Aaron Carter.
Hey, he had a bit of a comeback himself. It wasn't good. It was actually probably worse for his image, but he did have a comeback.
He's doing like a bit or something the other day of him, like, he shaved his head completely bald and then he was like using hairspray.
Mm.
Did he light himself on fire?
I don't know, but I was like, is this genius or are you just really off?
Yeah,
are you just done for? Are you cooked?
I think he came out with the album Aaron's Party and then his brain broke.
I think he has drug-induced psychosis. And once you do that to your brain, it's very hard to come back to normal.
I see.
Which is a bummer.
But you can just like retcon. You can just headcanon that he's a genius.
That's very good.
Oh, yeah, he's great.
Yeah.
Legend.
It's Pikachu!
It's test that premise.
Fuck!
Have you heard the phrase the gift of gab?
I just thought of that phrase today.
Really?
Yeah. About a guy named Darkside Phil.
Hmm. But yeah, so people saying they have the gift of gab, and it's like, what the fuck does that mean? Like as a child, are parents talking like, oh, my son is learning violin, he's at a level whatever the fuck, he's even speaking Mandarin. And the other lady's like, well, my child has the gift of gab. What does that mean? He just won't shut the fuck up.
that's pretty good.
God gave you so many gifts. A beautiful smile, gab.
That kid speaks Honeycrisp.
That's the Honeycomb guy.
Oh shit, what's the Honeycrisp?
Honeycrisp is the apple.
Yeah, well, you said an orange, so yeah.
Oh, my bad.
Pretty good. All right, same time next week,
dude.
Absolutely.
Oh, screw.
Dude. Yeah, absolutely.
Dude, absolutely.